So many brothers gone now, so many sisters too, who were chained in the mine when you broke our families, you sealed our fate.
A powerful poem being read on a somber day in Brantford. Dozens sitting just feet away from where a search for unmarked graves is being conducted at what was once considered to be one of the longest running residential schools.
Well, I think they'll find something, that's for sure. Yeah, but it's just taken a long time, and but I'm glad they got started.
At the helm of this search is the Survivors Secretariat, whose mandate is to uncover, document, and share the truth about what happened during the operation at the Mohawk Institute. The school opened in 1828 and remained in operation for more than 130 years.
This is heavy work that needs to be done. As survivors, we take comfort in knowing that this secret work is being done in a good way with community members' participation. We have been clear that the search must be survivor-led and community involved.
The search will cover close to 500 acres surrounding the former Mohawk Institute. It's a joint effort with a number of police services and the community that will use two ground-penetrating radar machines that will be used for grid searches. On hand as well was a number of survivors that were taken from their families and forced to stay at the Mohawk Institute.
Like my one younger sister was molested here by the minister a couple times, but that didn't happen to me. But I think the more I tell my story, because to me it's all about the impacts of living in a violent atmosphere, you know, an uncaring place, you know, where you got strapped all the time for, to me, minor things that kids did.
To date, more than 1,000 unmarked graves have been discovered across Canada. City News will provide the website where you can get more information of the Survivors Secretariat's efforts. It also has the phone numbers for mental health supports for both survivors and intergenerational survivors. All that information can be found at citynews.ca/extras. In Brantford, I'm Brandon Rowe for City News.